Today we're going to do something a little different. A couple of users have requested that I do the tutorials in VS Code with Platform.io. So after playing with it for a while, at first having trouble, I've discovered that I can see their reasoning for it. So this tutorial is going to show you how to install it on your SKR by Big Tree Tech. Now keep in mind, the SKR I purchased with my own money, and no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do the tutorial, but I will be putting links in the description to show you how to load the Marlin firmware on this, as well as where you can find the affiliated links for the SKR by Big Tree Tech. So first thing I'm going to show you is how to connect the USB. Now on the SKR, it has a PF drive that comes natively with the board, and this will allow us to load firmware. So if you haven't seen my basics tutorial, this might not make a lot of sense, so I suggest watching it. But I'm going to connect the other end of the USB serial to the computer, and you'll hear a beep. Okay, to start with, as you can see, with the USB attached to the computer, we can now see firmware.cur. It's a cursor file. It exists after a firmware load. So that's what's on your TF drive on your SKR. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna learn how to install VS Code. So I'm gonna go to my web browser and I'm gonna type VS Code. I'm gonna go to the download site for this. And as you can see, it's downloading rather quick because apparently it's not that big. So what we'll do after this is we'll install it, which is pretty simple. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to Show in Folder. You're gonna double click on it. You're gonna accept the N license agreement with this bullet. Then you're gonna go next. The directory is fine, so next. That's fine as well, so we'll go next. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a desktop icon, and I'm also gonna add it to the path so that we can easily find it. So let's click next. And then we're going to install with another install on the click. Now the install is pretty quick on my machine. It should be relatively quick on yours as well. So after it finishes, it's going to ask if we want to open it. So we'll say finish and let it open. And inside here, what we need to do is familiarize ourselves real quick. So this is your Explorer, this is your search, this is your source code controls, something like Git or SVN. Then you have your debug, and then you have your extensions. In this case, we're gonna load the extension for Platform.io, so I'm gonna click on that, and I'm gonna say Platform.io. And at the very top of the list, it has Platform.io IDE, so we're gonna click on that. Then we're going to click install. This may take a moment. It may request that you install other things as well. It should pop up down here, or it will install them for you. That's fine. But in my case, I've uninstalled and reinstalled so many times, it doesn't really matter. So we're all set there. We're going to populate the Platform.io icon and give us our functionality. But seeing how we have none to work with right now because we have nothing loaded, we need firmware. So we're going to go to the Marlin website. Oop, let me go back here actually and reload the extension while we go to the Marlin website. So I'm going to click on a new tab and I'm going to say marlinfw.org and press enter. Then I'm going to click on download. And then down here, because we're working with a 32-bit board, we have to use the 2.0 version of Marlin. So we're going to download Bugfix. This may take a moment. And the reason that this is because the previous versions are 8-bit that are above up here. So keep that in mind. That's why on a 32-bit board, you can do both 8-bit with the 2.0 version, and you can do 32-bit. So now that it's finished downloading, we're going to click on Show in Folder. And we're going to right-click on this, and we're going to extract all. So while this is extracting, we'll take a look at Atom, see if there's anything else that we need to load. So far, it doesn't say anything else that is requested. So let's just check over here, see if there's anything that's recommended that we don't already have. This tells us what's enabled right here. And then down here, you can actually check for your extensions to see what you have loaded. Some people say that you may need to load Git. That's up to you. If it's not working, you can always load Git. But for now, we're going to avoid that. And we're going to stick to Platform.io. So I'm guessing that we're almost done with our extract here. And as soon as this finishes, I'll show you how we can actually set up a build for Marlin for the SKR version 1.3. So as you can see, we have it right here. So in order to load it, what I normally do is I go over to here. I'll click on this field. And in here it says Open Project. So I'm going to go to my Downloads folder. And we have the extracted one right here, so I'm going to click on that. And inside there is another folder, so I'm going to click on that again. And then I'm going to say open. So now that it's open, there's going to be populated choices down here. Some of the interesting ones that you have are Platform.io Home. You have just your build. This is also known as compile. And then we have build and upload, which occur for upload. And then there's other interesting things, like you can connect to your board over here. This is a serial port monitor, so this will show us what our board is and what speed it is. So I'm going to click on this so that we can actually check our speed. I'm going to have to expand this field a little so you can actually see it. So what it's saying right here is what COM port we're on. It says what speed we're at, which is 250,000 bits per second, and then it talks about 8-bit parity and stuff like that, but these are really old functionality that I'm not going to go into too much detail on because it's really old school. But what we're going to go into is actually we're going to talk about how to load the firmware. So we're going to go to the source folder, then we're going to go to the core folder, then the boards.h folder. And inside here, we're going to look for our board, which is board_bigtree_skr_v1_3. So we're going to copy that. And then we're going to close out of this folder. And we're going to go to configuration.h. And we're going to scroll down to where it says motherboard. Now it's got the default board, which is board_ramps_14_EFB. We're going to paste our board type here. Unfortunately, I didn't copy very well, so I have to go back real quick. So we're going to go to the source folder, the core folder, boards.h, and we're going to copy our board again. And then back to config and paste. We also need to go up here and change our serial port from 0 to -1. And we're going to change our end stop just so we can see something that's changed, so that we have an idea of what's maybe occurring. Because normally these will show up as enabled, but we're going to change this one to true so that it says open, and that's going to be our Z minimum. We're all set there. Now we need to go to platform.io.ini. And what we need to do is change our environment from the Mega 18 Mega 2560 to what our chipset is, which is the LPC1768. And the reason I know this is I've done way too many tutorials on this, and you've probably seen way too many times where I've changed this, but that's okay. So first I'm going to show you how to actually do a build. Now this may not come out the way we like. You may have to build the second time because sometimes there's errors. So let's see what happens. Now keep in mind, down below, you can also do build with the checkbox. But in this case, we're going to do it over here, where we did it up here. Now upload also is considered build. And then it pushes it to the connected device. In this case, it would be the SKR version 1.3. And there are other functionality that I'd like to point out while I'm here. Erase flash I would stay away from because sometimes it's hard to reload your flash when there's nothing that'll accept. Depends on the actual hardware and software that's loaded on your board initially. I don't know what set fuses is. I don't know what upload set fuses is. A lot of these functions I don't know, but I can tell you that there's there should be a clean command. Now it might not be easily found. So here it is. This will actually wipe out what was in the previous build if there's something that you're trying to clear out that doesn't normally clear. Normally it would overwrite, but sometimes it doesn't, so the clean command is a way to flush your current build. Now keep in mind, the reason that these are important is if you go back to your actual source code over here, which is this little tab or explorer, you have a folder that's being created during your build, which is called the .pio folder. This is where everything's being stored for your build. So the .pio will create a build folder. Inside the build folder will be your chipset. And inside your chipset, eventually, what will display is actually the firmware.bin. Now you have the option of either copying it out of here manually to your TF or SD drive, and then plugging it into your BigTree Tech SKR version 1.3, or you can load it via upload. So it looks like it's getting pretty close to being done. Looks like we haven't had a failure. Just to let you know, I actually had a failure on my first initial build a couple of times today, but it appears not to be occurring for me anymore. If it does occur for you, you can always go over to platform.io and then rebuild, and it should, in theory, if you followed the exact same steps I followed, build no problem the second time. So we're getting pretty close to finishing the build over here. So what we're going to do, see, this is the last step in the build process. It will actually show us in a moment if there's success or failure. So as you can see, it says that one was successful, so we can scroll up here. And we can see that the LPC1768 did work for us. Now keep in mind, there is a warning over here. This shows actually if there's a problem with the build, but it won't interfere with a completed build if it's just a warning. But if you do have a error, which is the next one over to the left, that could cause your build to fail, but that's an easy way to check. So I'll show you how to check the warning real quick. You just click on it. And as you can see, this is the warning that we got. This has to do with the display. It's no big deal in this current situation, so we're not going to worry about it. But over here, we have something interesting. We can actually see if our serial port is connected by clicking here, and it will tell us what COM port we're on and what speed we're traveling at for bits. So in order to get out of that, you have to hit Control C to disconnect. Otherwise, you may remain connected when you're trying to connect to something like Pronterface. So instead of going through how to show you how to copy it manually, I'm going to show you how to upload directly. This will be a lot quicker. So I'm going to click the upload button, which also exists up here. And what'll happen is the build should, in theory, be briefer because most of the files are already created for you. So we'll give it a moment and we'll check out to see if we have anything else interesting to talk about here. Now, test didn't work for me. This is clean over here, this little garbage can. And then we have home, which is the same as, well, it takes you to the home. I don't know exactly where that is, so let's click it and see what happens. So it takes you to platform IO home up here. But currently we don't need to worry about that, so it's okay. So right about now, it should be getting close to doing an upload. Okay, now that it's finished, we can verify once again that it actually worked for the chipset that we have in question, which it appears to have done. And now it looks like it's uploaded. So what we can do is cheat. We can go over to the USB drive, and sure enough, it actually uploaded to our USB drive. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to disconnect manually the USB for a moment. So this will drop away. And I'll reconnect it and it'll pop back up. And as you can see, the time is updated from the time that the build completed. So we're going to test this real quick. So I'm going to go to my desktop and I'm going to open up my print run directory for Pronerface. I'm going to open up Pronerface for you. We're going to connect to the actual SKR version 1.3, and I'm going to type M119 to check the changes that we made for the end stop. So as you can see, the Z-axis that we inverted the logic for says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.